Hey everybody, this is Alex with GuitarForce.com. Today's lesson on Barracuda by heart. And it was another supported request by Mark, so thank you very much. This song is really interesting. It has two guitar parts. Some are the same, some are different, but we'll get to that during the lesson. And also it has a solo section, which is going to be in this lesson as well. If you're interested in downloading the tabs and the backing track, you can do so by going to GuitarForce.com. The tabs you're going to find under the video, just click on it and that's it. And the backing track is going to be in the free backing track section. As far as the sound, again, I was using the VST plugin Guitar Rig with two different presets. And again, I'm going to post two pictures of these two presets on the screen for you to see. And while you're checking out the pictures, this song is in standard tuning, so here is my low E for your tuning reference. Okay guys, so without further ado, let's take a listen to the intro part, then we'll come back and start the lesson. Let's check it out. So for the intro part, we have a riff which is played four times by guitar number one, and it's using sort of gallop figure. It goes like this, played on the low E string open. Okay, so we have an eighth note followed by two 16th notes. And you can add also the power chord, to create like a bigger sound, but if you play it on the low E string, is going to be all right. So we have this gallop figure going on, and then after that we add two power chords. The one is F sharp going to G, so we have this. After that, after we've played the power chord, we then add some harmonics. So the first one is going to be on the 12th fret. So you can hit like D, G and the B strings. And then after that, we have another harmonics which have been played on the 5th fret. So all together. And then you add these scooped notes with the vibrato, with the tremolo arm. Okay, and practically that's the riff that we're playing four times. So this is the first time. Second time we play a little bit different second part of this riff. So again we have the gallop. Now this time, while we are on the G chord, we add the higher strings open. And right before the drums kick in, we have this just a quick effect, which is played. The first time, it seems like he's playing on the 11th fret, the D and a G strings, diving it with the tremolo arm, and then kind of sliding fast into the 12th fret and then sliding out like that. Then we play again the riff, again adding harmonics. This time it's only on the 12th fret, only once, slide out, and then we play fourth time the riff. So again, now this last time, fourth time again, when we go to the G chord, we then add the higher strings open. And for this time, he adds the harmonics on the 12th fret. And again, presses on the tremolo arm to create this dive bomb effect of the notes. Now, this is the fourth time that we play this riff during the intro part. The second guitar comes onto the third and fourth time, and it's playing exactly the same thing, with the exception of he plays different harmonics. So all the time he plays on the seventh. So it goes like this. One more time. You know, you can just add some variation here regarding the tremolo arm. So that's the intro riff. Now we go to the verse, and it sounds like this. So during the verses, we have two guitars again playing same riff, but then we have different parts. So we're going to break them down into two parts, two guitars. Guitar number one, like I said, is playing again the same main riff, which is the gallop. Now the structure-wise, it changes here a little bit. So we're going to be playing the gallop figure for two bars, and then we have first beat of the third bar also gallop, and then the power chord is going to come onto the second beat of the third bar. Okay, so we have this 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, 1, right? And then after the gallop we play the C power chord, and now the first guitar here is holding on to it for bar and a half, and then adds this lick, which is the first time that he plays, goes like this. So just sliding using this double stop on the D and a G strings at the 7th fret to the 9th fret, and then again hitting that 7th fret and sliding out. Now he does that only the first time during the first verse. After that he changes it a little bit, and he plays like that. So basically it's a sort of a G chord sliding to A, and then we have from D to E, but you can hear that he's mostly has an accent on these double stops. So on the 5th fret A and D strings, sliding up to the 7th fret, and then on the D and the G, again two strings at the same time from 7 to 9. So in context is going to be like this. Like that, okay? Now, like I said, you can still play the sort of power chord, G to A and then D to E. But if you accent, if you play only these double stops, is gonna sound just fine. So this is guitar number one, playing that part during the verses. Guitar number two is playing slightly different. So after the gallop figure, when he plays the C chord, he then follows the bass basically, and the bass goes. So C to B to A to G, and guitar number one follows the bass and plays kind of chords with the bass. So we start with C, then all we do just shift that first finger one fret down to the second fret. Okay, so it's gonna be like that. Then we play A chord, and the last note is G. Okay, so that's both guitars during verse one. After that we go into pre-chorus and chorus, and they sound like this. You lie so- Okay, so for the pre-chorus, the first figure we have this. So both guitars are playing exactly the same thing. And here we start off with the C power chord, then going into this where we move the first finger one fret down to the second fret, while the pinky still holds the G note right here. So this could be looked at as the first inversion of the G chord, for example. So from C to the G with the B in the bass. Then we play A note and we slide out. Okay, so we have this. And then we have the E power chord play in a specific rhythmical figure. So we have. Like that. Now for the second part of the pre-chorus is where it's getting interesting. Now I can hear three parts played at the same time. Now if we break them down into each one on its own, the first one is going to be like this. Okay, second is going to be like this. And the third. Okay, so now when we put all of these parts together, of course, it's harder to play all three parts on one guitar, but there are a couple of ways how you can play this riff. Now, the first one is using the fourths, okay, and you kind of can combine the fourths and thirds because that's the second part, which is using thirds, but you can definitely hear the fourths. So what I did, I kind of combined two of the parts on one guitar and then two of the parts on the second guitar. And so that way some of the parts are going to repeat, but that's okay. And the first way to play it is like this. You start on the third fret with the low E and the A string, then we go to the fifth fret, to the seventh, and then go back down by using thirds, like that. So third, fifth, seventh, played in fourths, and then we go down in thirds. Now on the A string we have fifth, and on the D fourth. Major third, go down a step, so third fret on A, second fret on D. Then we have on the second fret of the A string an open D. And then we have this minor third, which is third fret on A string, fifth fret on the low E. So all together. And now again we alternate this with the power chord. The second way how you can play it by using the thirds only would be like this. So we start on the A string 3rd fret, D string 2nd fret, move the whole shape one step up. So we have two major thirds. Then we have a minor third, so now on A we're going to have 7, on D we have 5. Go back down, and basically again we have... you can finish it off with exactly the same notes. So on the A 2nd fret, the D open, and then the minor third again. Okay, so it's a little bit tricky, but... you can mess around and find your own way how to play it, okay? And if you're playing two guitars in a band or something, you know, you can use both ways. So this is the second part of the pre-chorus. Like that, all right? And then for the chorus, which is just two chords, we play D. You can play either here or here. One guitar can play right here, the second guitar here, And then we have A chord for one bar. Then we have a stop, and then we go back to the intro part. All right, so as we play the intro second time between the verses, it's exactly the same as the first intro, and the guitars are playing exactly the same riffs as in the first intro, with the exception of the second guitar, which is playing some harmonics, which go like this. So here what we do, we play harmonic on the 12th fret of the high E string, then go to the G string, 7th fret, next one B12, D string at the 7th, G12, A7, and then D12, and the last one is going to be on the B string, 5th fret. Okay, and the goal here is to make harmonics sort of ring out. So we play the first one, and then right away into the second, and then let them ring out. Then we go to B string. Okay, so creating this harmony. Now the guy from the Heart who played these harmonics, he actually used different places for these harmonics, so the harmonics that are played on the 12th fret are staying at the same position, 12, but the harmonics which we're playing on the 7th fret, instead of the 7th fret, he would play them down here or up here on the 19th fret. Like that. And that is because these harmonics are exactly the same as harmonics here. Okay, so it's sort of a mirror image if we take it from the 12th fret as the center, you know, it's going to be the same. These are the same harmonics. So he also used his arm like that, you know, I guess for visual effect or something. You know, either way works, so whatever works for you, use that. Alright, so after that we go into the second verse, pre-chorus and chorus, which are exactly the same as the first ones, with the only exceptions, we add again a little effect there, which is a trill between the parts when played the second verse. And the trill is happening on the D string between open and second fret. And it's, like I said, between the parts, so it would go something like this. Okay, so between these two parts we add this trill on the D string between open and second fret. Then we play the pre-chorus and the chorus exactly the same way as we did in the first pre-chorus and chorus, and after that we go into middle section, which sounds like this.